which model of selling on Amazon using FBA is the best fit for you moving forward, going from 2019 to 2020? Let's dive in. Figuring out which model of selling on Amazon is extremely important, and it's got to be the right fit for you based on a bunch of factors. You know, the capital that you have access to, the time commitment that you want to give, as well as what's your good fit for your personality and for your business, okay? So there's three main types of selling on Amazon, and I want to start with what I think is the most straightforward. I don't want to say easy, but it's a little bit more straightforward, and then I'll get more complicated as we go. And the three main types are retail arbitrage, selling on wholesale, and then private labeling. And so we sell pretty much 80%, 85% is all private labels. So we have a couple seven-figure brands, and we're starting to expand our wholesale operations. And I'm gonna go into why we're doing that. There's a lot of benefits to all these different models. I know guys that do seven and eight figures using all these different models. And so it's just a matter of making the business work for you and hustling so that you can figure out, you know, what's going to be the best way for you to scale. And depending on where you are in your circumstance, you might have time or you might have budget to start with one, and such as retail arbitrage, and not the others. So let's go through. So the first one I want to talk about is retail arbitrage. So retail arbitrage is essentially you're just finding products in retail stores and you're flipping them on Amazon. Okay. So you're going down to the stores, you're going to TJ Maxx, going to Walmart, and you're pulling out your the Amazon app and you're scanning the products to see what it's selling for on Amazon. And so if you see a product in Walmart that you can get on clearance for 15 bucks, and then you can go flip it for 35, 40 bucks on Amazon, you can make a quick profit on that sale. And if you do that for 10, 20, 30, 40, 50 products per day, then you can do some really nice flips, okay? So obviously, there's gonna be pros and cons to all these models, so I wanna dive into some of the pros. So you definitely need less capital to start a retail arbitrage business, okay? So I know plenty of people that are doing this with $100, $200, $300, $500, they're going down to the store, and they're going and they're buying, you know, 25 pairs of Nikes and a bunch of toys, and they're going and flipping them. And it's not uncommon to go and make $1,000 to $3,000 per weekend using this model. So it's also, you know, you can profit at scale. It's also a very good way to learn the Amazon business without diving deep into having too much capital investment. So you can learn how the Amazon platform works. You can, you know, you can research products, and then you can learn about shipping, logistics, and all those things that help you kind of get comfortable with the Amazon platform if you want to grow your business and start doing other types of models. Okay. So who is retail arbitrage for? Because it does require a lot of time. And so let's talk about some of the negatives. You know, obviously you're going to be on the road going to the physical stores, so it needs a lot of time to go and constantly be finding these products, okay? So it takes time and you got to travel, so it's gas, and it's a commitment. And then you need to go to these stores and you constantly need to be hunting and finding these deals. And sometimes, you know, you're arguing with the manager of the store because they don't want you to buy all the stuff that's on the clearance shelf, okay? So that's a con as well. Another negative is I'm starting to see more and more people get shut down because they don't necessarily have permission to sell specific items. So you have to get permission to sell branded items. And so Amazon's getting harsher and shutting these people down. So, you know, this is for someone that you know, either has a job or doesn't have a lot of capital and wants to get going selling on Amazon, kind of building it out as a side hustle. People have been doing it for years and it's still going. But in 2020, you're going to see Amazon starting to crack down more and more and get more strict with people that don't have proper invoices, don't have proper permissions to sell some of these branded products. Okay. So, you know, there are some good and bad things to retail arbitrage. Personally, I don't have the effort to go out and find these products. I, you know, like doing everything from my computer. I don't want to hold the inventory, which is why we'll get into private label. So the second model is called selling wholesale. So wholesale is essentially you are finding popular products that are already selling really well on the Amazon platform, and you're going directly to the supplier and you're opening up an account, okay? And then you're buying directly from them, and then you're shipping them Amazon and flipping and making margins and profits on each one of those units. Why are we doing more wholesale? Well, while we're waiting for our private label products to be manufactured and developed, we're talking to suppliers and we can get a couple of cases of a product and I can buy it for X and then I can make, you know, 10, 20, 30% margins on these products while I'm waiting for my private label products to come in. Okay. So some of the positives I would say are you can buy in bulk. And then once you find proper products that are profitable and you have good relationships, then you can go super deep on these and you can buy a lot. And it's gonna give you a lot of churn, and it's gonna be selling continuously 24/7. So these are high demand products, and you know that because you can use tools to look at the Amazon data and basically say, okay, this is already has a BSR that's lower than 30,000, and it's already selling 1,000 units per month. I can go in and I can compete with a couple other sellers that are selling this product. Once I open the account with that supplier, I'm gonna get that product and I'm gonna capture some of those sales. And so I know that I'm gonna make profit on that product. Okay. It's very liquid in the sense that you can get inventory in and be selling through that inventory in 4 weeks, 8 weeks, 3 months, and then you have that cash right back in, then you invest that into new products. Okay. And so that kind of leads us to, it's a very scalable business model. So once you've got some products going, then you can scale quickly because it's also a model where with the right reputation, you can open up more and more accounts and you get more approval in different categories that you need from Amazon. Just as long as you are very organized and you can keep all your invoices and your POs, then wholesale is a good model for you. Now, what are the downsides to wholesale? Well, it requires a lot of vendor outreach. So you need to do a lot of research. You need to be kind of always hustling and convincing these suppliers that you are worthy of their products and that you can handle managing the inventory and that you're going to represent their products on the marketplace properly. Okay, so they want to know that you're a good seller, because if you're going to be an official reseller or distributor for them, then they want to know who you are. So having some of that, you know, salesmanship and business, it's all about relationships with wholesale. Okay, you need a lot more capital to start. So whereas retail arbitrage, you can do $500 and turn that into $1,000. With wholesale, you might want to have $5,000, $10,000 in capital, because some of these accounts are not even going to take you seriously unless you can place like a legitimate order. They're not going to let you buy, you know, minimum order quantity of $500 worth of product. They're going to want you to buy $5,000, $10,000, $15,000 worth of product. And the bigger you go with the supplier and the more name brand that you're going to be going after, they're going to want you to buy more in bulk. There's less margins than in the other models. Not that there are margins. It's just that you're buying it from a middleman. So, you know, when you go to sell on Amazon, you're also competing with other sellers that are selling that same exact product. So, you know, you don't want to be selling at 10% higher than everyone else because you're not going to win the buy box. You're not going to win that sale. And the customer doesn't know you. They know the brand that they're buying. You know, they know, I don't know, Colgate toothpaste, but they don't know you. So if you're selling Colgate 10% higher than everyone else, you're not going to get that sale. And you need business acumen. It's all about relationships. It's all about numbers. You have to be really organized. You have to know inventory management. You have to be able to stay on top of everything. Once you have those vendor relationships, it's very easy to kind of just send an email and say, hey, I want to re-up and repurchase. And the goal and the way you can win on a wholesale is when you can get those 30 and 60 day net terms where you actually don't have to pay for the inventory until 30 or 60 days later, which really helps because now you can wait for those sales to come in and then you can pay for your bills. So that alleviates some of the pressure from needing all that cash up front. Just the sheer volume of selling wholesale mixed with, you know, the margins makes it a very scalable model. And, you know, some of the people that are doing 7 and 8 figures, it didn't take them long to get there. A lot of folks can do, you know, 500,000 or 1 million in their first year and then kind of go from there. You're going to need possibly a warehouse with some staff, depending on how big or how scalable you get. Okay. What's going to change in 2020? Amazon's really getting particular cracking down on fraudulent accounts. So you better have your invoices and your POs in order, because Amazon will shut you down. Doesn't matter if you're doing $50 million a year, they will shut you down. On the positive side, in 2020, I mean, the global marketplaces for Amazon is just, they're just growing. They're just growing. We just launched new products on Australia, which is growing. We're going to do Dubai. We're going to be some of the first people in Dubai. It's getting bigger. So for wholesale, we do a lot of US and we're doing a lot of Europe. Okay. So we know that the products are going to be very popular in those places, but there's going to be way more opportunities as these marketplaces, as these global marketplaces get bigger. And as Amazon just becomes more and more a part of our everyday life, it's just going to get bigger. So if you can form those vendor relationships, then you can, the sky's the limit for wholesale. I'm excited to kind of build out our wholesale operation. We do have a warehouse in North Carolina. So we, you know, we ship a lot of our private label products on FBM as well. So we have a lot of the operations and logistical stuff in place. So I'm confident that we can do a nice mixture of private label and wholesale. And so let's talk about the last model, one that takes a certain level of patience. It is by no means a get rich quick process, but it's extremely rewarding when done properly. And the last model is private label. So I started selling in 2016. I made a lot of mistakes about private label, but then quickly figured out how to research and find and launch profitable products. And so how can you win a private label? So private label is essentially you're looking for opportunities on the market. You're looking for either existing products that have room for improvement, whether it's physical improvement on the product, or you're just going to drastically improve the listing, the photography, the keywords, the optimization, the front and the back end, the bullets, or you're, you know, slightly, you're introducing a unique product and you're building a moat around yourself. You're protecting yourself by offering something to the market that nobody else can sell, which is a little risky if nobody wants that product. So you better know that there's demand for the keywords and for that type of product, right? So private label is one of my favorite things because you can build a brand around your products. And that is extremely valuable. So I sold my first FBA business in 2017, and now we have three brands across two accounts, and we can continuously launch new branded private label products and keep growing and just collecting cash flow, or we can sell that private label brand. So there are a lot of people out there that don't want to spend the time and energy investing and learning how to do Amazon. They just want to buy private label brands. And you can do that when it's your own brand. You can't do that when you're selling, you know, someone else's product. So you can do that for yours. You know, the pros are you can build your own brand and that gives you a lot more control. Okay, you control exactly everything about the product. You can control how the listing feels. You can control all the marketing around it. You need to do your math right, but the margins on private label are really nice, anywhere from, you know, 30 to 50 to 70% margins, depending on the category that you're in. There's much less hijackers, so there's more protection, especially when you get a brand trademark. So if you get brand registry, then you can really protect your brand and you can make sure no one sells, you know, your product. And as soon as you see someone selling some type of counterfeit, if you have brand registry, Amazon will take them down immediately. You can collect customer information by doing smart things like product inserts, putting your website somewhere on your physical packaging and getting people to come over into your world, your ecosystem, and collecting their email, their phone number, like getting them on a chat bot. And then you can market additional products to them and you can build up a customer list and just do retargeting marketing for them. And you can do amazing things like today is Black Friday. You know, we had a great Black Friday today, and being able to launch a sale to our customers is invaluable, especially when you've got your own list, okay? And when you're selling your private label brand, having that list really makes it enticing to a buyer. That leads us into, you want to scale another product, you want to scale by launching more products, okay? So, you know, private label is just, it's really fun to build a brand. It takes some know-how. You have to know how to launch your products properly. It takes, you know, some of the downsides. It takes a little bit more time and effort because you're working directly with a supplier to finesse a product. And so you need to get samples in, you need to touch and feel those samples. You need to design your logo and get your branding on there. It's not complicated by any means. It's just, you gotta take a couple extra steps. So if you're willing to do some of that work, if you're willing to go out and talk to a couple of suppliers and talk to three suppliers, talk to five suppliers and get some samples in and pick the best one and then work with that supplier and build a relationship, then you can build up a really nice private label product. But yeah, it does take time and effort. You need to know how to launch, right? You need to know one of the most important things on private label. You don't really have any social proof when you launch a product. So you need to know how to get sales and you need to get reviews. So we have full launch processes that incorporates driving external traffic from things like Facebook and chatbots that gets customers into our ecosystem, drives them to Amazon. We control which keywords we want to rank for, because the more keywords that you rank for, the more your product is going to show up in search and the more sales you're going to get. And you need to know how to do PPC. And if you knew how to do all those things, then your launch can be really successful, but you do need to put some effort into a launch. But once you know how to do a launch, it's very easy to do a rinse and repeat. It's very easy to do that over and over again for all your products. And again, once you have a customer list, boom, you just hit them and say, hey, we got this new product coming out. Love to get some feedback on it. You know, we're going to give it to you at a discount, and you can go and you can make some really nice progress on your launch in the honeymoon period when you launch. You need to know how to negotiate with suppliers, because you're going to be going back and forth with suppliers, whether it's domestic or somewhere in China or Vietnam, and you need to know how to go out and negotiate your numbers so that you are making the profits that you're going for. And making sure that you're hitting your ROI. You know, it's a little bit riskier because it's a brand new product. No one necessarily knows your brand, so you need to build that up. So you need to get that social proof, and you need to, you know, get people to come to trust your product. And you do that by A, bringing a lot of value to the marketplace by launching an awesome product, B, having a kick-ass listing, some beautiful photography, and C, having some really nice marketing around it. So all those things you can do to circumvent some of that risk. And again, that risk comes with higher reward. And then you need to diversify enough just so that you're not completely putting all your eggs in one basket. Because if you do launch a private label product and it doesn't sell well, then you've lost that capital. But if you have a diversification, or if you've launched a product that wasn't that expensive, you can probably break even on that product, okay? But I would say the more you diversify, the more products you launch, the bigger you can scale your private label business. It's also, again, going back to being more attractive to a buyer. Another thing you have to watch out for is Amazon is launching their own private label brands, right? So I'm not gonna go and launch my version of Amazon Basics, you know, bed sheets. They sell baby products. Like, you gotta know what Amazon, their private label brands are. And if you see that it's a private label brand, then you don't want to go up and compete with that, because A, they can compete on price. Obviously, they're not taking their own, you know, referral and pick and pack fee. And they buy in such bulk and they have such scale that they've got those economies of scale, so they can get everything a lot cheaper. And so they can charge a lot less. You know, in the end, if you think long term and you understand the marketing, want to own something and build a company and build a brand that's sustainable and long term, private label is absolutely a fantastic business model on Amazon. And again, you take advantage of FBA. So other than touching the samples, you never have to hold or touch any of your inventory. So those are the three types of models, and you can really make any of them work for you if you do the work, if you put the effort into it. There's no, you know, working 1 hour a week to making seven figures. You know, we put a lot of time into our brands, into our customers. And on the wholesale side, we're opening up more and more vendor accounts, because that just means more sales for us, right? So all that takes time and effort, but it comes back in money, in profit. You know, whether you want to hit seven figures, whether you want to hit eight figures, figuring out which model works for you is extremely important. And I implore you to watch a lot of YouTube videos on all these things. Subscribe to my channel. I do a lot on private label. I've got some training on private label. And the more I get comfortable with wholesale, the more I'm going to be talking about that as well. But, you know, selling on Amazon is just incredible. it's getting bigger and bigger. We've got next day shipping now. We've got, you know, what, like 16 or 18 global marketplaces. They're building Amazon warehouses all over the world. So it's never been a better time to get in as e-commerce just keeps getting bigger and bigger and bigger. Okay. So, you know, get into Amazon. Good luck on your journey. And, you know, leave a comment below. Let me know if I missed anything or if you are selling on one of these models and having awesome success, or if you have any questions, issues, love to hear about it. Subscribe, and thanks so much for watching. Bye.